I can hear you well, sir.
But what's the name?
R. Aishwarya, sir.
Let me. R. Aishwarya.
Yes, sir.
Let me start.
Yes.
Yeah. Vanakkam.
Vanakkam, sir.
Aishwarya, can you introduce yourself to the board, please? Panel, yes. About your background.
Good afternoon, sirs. My name is Aishwarya and I am from Kadalur, Tamil Nadu. I have completed my engineering in Civil Engineering, College of Engineering, Guindy, Anna University. And I am presently posted as Indian Railway Account Service Probationer in Indian Railway Institute of Financial Management, Secunderabad.
So what about your family background, parents?
Yes, sir. My father is in agriculture and my mother is in school education department working as assistant officer, sir.
Brothers, sisters, nobody is there. Siblings? Your siblings?
Sorry, sir, I didn't get that. Siblings, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I have an elder sister and a younger brother. Both of them are into civil service preparation, sir.
So all in civil service?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. So you studied in Guindy, eh?
Yes, sir.
Can you give me the historical importance of this particular place, that engineering institution?
So this is a first technical institution to be established in India. Actually, it was established in 1796 by a British an engineer called Michael Topping. That time it was called a School of Architecture, surveying school, and later it got developed into a university, sir. And IIT Rourkela has been recognized as one of the oldest engineering college, but even before that, College of Engineering Guindy existed, sir.
It's supposed to be the oldest in Asia, I was told. Oldest institute in Asia, not India.
Sir, that I'm not sure of that, sir.
You're not sure?
Yes, sir.
So, what are your options in the civil service?
Sir, my optional subject is sociology, sir.
Sociology.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
So, I just want to ask that, that what happened in Tuticorin just around 2 weeks back?
That, yes, sir.
Father and son, they were taken to police station. They were tortured, I suppose, and they died in police custody.
Yes, sir.
So why that is happening and all? It's like same thing what happened in the US, like racism, criticism that discrimination against the poor people, something like that. Police, yes, brutality in Tamil Nadu.
Yes, sir. It's an unfortunate incident, sir. But the reasons in which led to this situation in both the countries, I think it is different, sir. In US, it is a long existing racism culture between them, sir, between blacks and Americans. And here in India, this is caused because of the high-handedness of police in few instances that while enforcing lockdown. And I don't think there is any racism or caste component behind this incident, sir. It is utterly because of a pure revenge act, and I don't think we can compare both incidents. But one thing common is that police as an institution has should become more public friendly, and the one who upholds the law and protects people. But that angle has been a little that we have moved away from that mainstream, sir, where police should protect the people. That component is forgotten, sir.
You heard that concept called Friends of Police, FOP, Friends of Police?
Yes, sir. It's a volunteer program where a common public can act as informers to police, sir.
So what I heard, I read about that because I am from the police, that these people are being used by the police department for doing all sorts of custody, taking people into, taking even arrest, then doing all sorts of nonsense. And this particular case also, 3-4 volunteers are involved in this particular case also. So as a result, I think the government of Tamil Nadu has cancelled that program now. It's just 4 days back. The Friends of Police has been abolished in Tamil Nadu. So, are you aware of that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But I believe abolishment is not the solution, sir. Initially, it was started with the focus of engaging community in the policing and for maintaining law and order. Sudden abolition is not good, sir. I recommend rationalizing or restructuring of that program by introducing the more citizen-friendly measures, sir.
So you happened, what happened in Tamil Nadu, that then UP also one criminal, they were raided and they killed the police officers. Then this guy also got killed with the police encounter, the cold police encounter yesterday morning.
Yes, sir.
What
yes,
is his name?
I am aware of that, sir. Vikas Dubey, sir.
So there's no hesitation at all. Nobody hesitated against that. That police, they said it's a force encounter, but nobody hesitated about that. So are we accepting violence by the police?
Sir, the criminal justice system starts with the police, and I believe it should end with judiciary and prison.
So, but he ended with the police only.
Even with police itself, sister, sir, that I don't recommend it, sir.
So India as a society, like what happened in the Hyderabad, one doctor was raped, and there similar situation was there. Then four people, they were shown that they were trying to snatch weapons, then they were shot, and public was celebrating the police and showering flowers.
Yes,
so are we encouraging violence in uniform as a society?
Sir, as a society, there is an outrage against the pendency of cases, sir. And so they believe that instant justice given by police is much more efficient. But that should not be the case, sir. We should follow the due law process of law and order. We should follow all the laws and regulations to know what is the truth, what went behind all the cases. So this thing, any crime should undergo a trial process, and in the end only the truth will be uncovered. This instant thing, encounters are extrajudicial, and it's not constitutional, sir.
It's not constitutional. So how do we stop it? It's happening all the states and most of the states and for a long time. How do we stop it? What is the way out?
Sir, we should implement the police reforms, the police establishment board, where the complaints against police can be inquired into. And we should also clear the pendency of cases, so that all the under trials should be cleared, so that people will restore their faith in the judiciary system also, sir.
Okay, I'll hand over to Sarangi, sir.
Yes.
Aishwarya?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. You are in civil accounts?
Sorry, sir. That got upgraded into Indian Railway Account Service, sir.
Achha, Railway Account Service?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very nice. So, Railway has got how many services? 3-4 services they have.
Solutions, sir?
They have got 3-4 services.
Yes, sir. Like this, have 8 services in total, sir.
Achha, Railway Traffic then?
Account service, personal service, and then engineering services. Sir.
Protection force.
Railway protection
force. Now there is a talk that all those services should be combined.
Yes, sir.
You have heard about that?
Yes, sir.
All the 8 different services should be combined, so that there is no interdepartmental stress. Okay. So what about that? Is it happening or not?
Yes, sir. It is happening at a fast pace, I believe, sir, because the recruitments to the IRAS, IRPS services have been stopped in the UPSC 2020 notification, sir. And this is happening in a good pace, but still the modalities are not yet clear, like how they would merge all the services at different levels.
Okay. They say Rail India is Real India. You agree with this?
Yes, sir. India, Indian Railways in itself is a mini India, where all the diversity is shown in the railways itself. First of all, it connects the entire country from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. And railways is also one of the reasons why India is united, both economically and politically. And other thing is that every Indian citizen gets to travel in the Indian Railways and has traveled in Indian Railways. That's how it reflects the Indian also, sir. And recruitment also, Indian Railways being the largest employer, here we railways people are from different parts of the country, and they themselves share a culture of India, sir. It's really a mini India, sir.
Okay. Very nice. Have you heard of generalized system of preferences with United States? Generalized system of preferences.
Yes,
have you heard of this?
Yes, I have heard of it, but I can't exactly recollect what it is. I think it's related to trade preferences.
No. They do not charge any tariffs from certain countries.
Okay, sir.
Can you expand that? Have you heard about it?
Yes, sir. I have read about it, sir, but currently I can't recall.
That is India and United States. United States, as per their trade act, to so many poor countries, they will not charge on certain items. They will not charge in tariff. But Mr. Trump waived that. He said, no, we'll charge India. Okay. So that was the relationship. Okay, thank you. If you have not heard, it's something. What are the four fundamental forces of nature?
Sir, Four fundamental forces of nature.
Have you heard of standard model in physics? Standard model in physics.
No, sir. Four fundamental forces I know, sir.
What are the four fundamental forces?
Sir, gravitational force, electromagnetic force. I can't take that.
Strong force, strong nuclear force, and weak nuclear force.
Okay.
They are the four forces, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So, now they say that there is a fifth force also. Have you heard about it?
Yes,
for time, for last so many hundreds of years, they had accepted there are four fundamental forces in nature. Okay, that means any activity, anything, can be converted into these four fundamental forces.
Yes, sir.
But now they say that there is a fifth fundamental force also. The latest development of science, maybe. They have not yet proved it, but there is a talk that there is a fifth fundamental force.
Okay.
Can you tell us what are gravity waves?
Gravitational waves, sir.
Yes.
Sir, if there is any cosmic interaction between two planetary bodies, then waves are...
They are much bigger than planets.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Massive bodies
like two black holes or any interplanetary systems, sir, like a nebula. That time, the energy which is released is called gravitational waves, sir.
So, the gravitational wave, what is the characteristic of a gravitational wave?
Sir, it creates a ripple effect in the space, sir, by bending...
We also have electromagnetic radiation also, and light,
yes, sir.
Light,
yes,
and other forms.
Yes, sir.
They are also emitted. But what is the difference between that and gravitational force?
Sir, gravitational waves tend to change the time and space, sir, some related to that.
Not changing time. Gravitational force, we can have more information on the beginning of the universe.
Yes.
Because light cannot enter the first 3 lakh years of the Big Bang. Hear about that. So light cannot enter. But gravitational waves, they can give us the information even of the beginning of the universe at the Big Bang.
Okay.
So the first lakhs of years are not opaque to gravity waves. So gravity waves can give us little more information on the beginning of the universe.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And light can be obstructed, but gravitational waves cannot be obstructed.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So there are some of the basic science things that I'm asking because you're an engineer. Okay. So have you heard of the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam?
Sorry, sir, I have never heard of
this. These are the major dams being constructed in Africa now.
Okay, sir.
Because why this is relevant is important affair, and because it is on Nile, and Nile water treaty is one of the biggest treaty between seven to six countries. So now, if this dam is constructed, now they have to again change the some of the fundamentals of the treaty. Okay, that's why it's very difficult. Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir.
All right. So, Miss Aishwarya.
Yes, sir.
So, you are from Kadalur, is it not?
Yes, sir.
And you have done your civil engineering.
Yes, sir.
So tell me, what are the latest innovations happening in your field of civil engineering?
Yes, sir. Mainly, they are experimenting with glazing, like embedding photovoltaic panels on glazing system so that can also generate electricity, solar voltaic panels. And the other thing would be kinetic footfall, where electricity can be generated by this mechanical force where people all walk on. This could be laid down in crowd walks areas and also. These are few technologies. And in building materials also, sulfate resistant cements are coming up, sir.
What about in terms of design of the building?
Design of the building, green building concept is going on, sir, where energy utilization can be minimized by optimum design of structures, sir. And the other thing would be energy saving buildings.
Now, you see, cement industry is the largest contributor, one of the largest contributors to greenhouse gases. It's almost 5% of the carbon dioxide is emitted by cement industry. So, first question is why it is high carbon footprint is there?
Second is that, do we have any alternative or are there innovations happening in this field?
So first of all, the manufacturing process of cement requires furnace burning. Yeah, this is the reason for carbon footprint. And
no, that may not be right, because that same thing is applicable for steel industry also. Okay. If you're talking in terms of burning coal, it is applicable to other industries also.
Okay, so then I believe this is one of the reasons.
Yeah, it has more to do with the raw material which is used. So what is the raw material which is used for cement?
Sand, silica, sir. Limestone.
Limestone, is it not? And what is limestone?
Limestone is calcium carbonate compound, sir.
So what happens when you heat limestone?
Yes, sir. Carbon dioxide gets released.
So that is a trapped carbon dioxide. It's a fossil fuel.
Oh, okay, sir.
It's a fossilized carbon which is out. So that is a major reason why there is a
increase in carbon footprint. And for coming to alternatives, I believe we can utilize the massive construction and demolition waste we already have in our country. And there's only few recycling facilities in India. Only two facilities are there, one in Delhi and one in Mumbai. I think this one we should scale up. The construction and demolition base could be recycled. And going for alternatives, we have fly ash, which could be reused, and also Yamsan can also be used in place of cement. Mostly, I believe recycling would be a better option, sir.
Something like green cement? For instance, you're not using limestone. Actually, you're producing limestone.
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of the concept, sir.
All right. You have mentioned that you like watching Asian dramas.
Yes, sir.
What is this?
Sir, Asian countries dramas, sir. Mainly China, Thailand, Japan, and even Korea. Korean dramas I like to watch mostly, sir.
So I'm not really going to ask you about Korean dramas, but I would like to know, have you heard about this book, Asian Drama, An Inquiry into the Poverty of Nations?
Yes, sir. It's written by Gunnar Myrdal, sir, the sociologist and economist, mainly about the world systems, how poverty is being perpetuated and created in countries. I have not read that book, sir, but I have read the review of that book, sir.
Okay. Maybe you could have a look into it, because the possibility when you mention Asian dramas, the possibility of Gunnar Myrdal's view on India, in fact, corruption and all that, you know, that could be a point for discussion.
Okay,
so maybe you could prepare yourself for that discussion. It's very highly likely that this will be asked.
Okay.
Now, since you talked about South Korea, what is the reason why the movie Parasite became such a popular movie? You know?
Yes, sir. Recently, that movie also got Oscar award, sir. There is a thing called Hallyu wave, where the Korean movie industry is reaching big markets. One such reason is that already growing popularity of Korean entertainment industry. And the other thing would be the unique storyline of that movie, sir, which brings out the class differences in the society. That is also one component, sir. I believe the growing limelight and focus on Korean entertainment would be one of the reasons of our focus, sir, because there are so many good movies which have been released in the past also in Korean industry, sir.
What are your hobbies? Table tennis and gardening also, you know?
Yes, sir. Sketching also.
What are the plants which is used, which can be used, which is more effective in vertical gardening?
So in vertical gardening, we can go for crotons, sir, because it requires only small space and watering also can be minimum. We can go for crotons like the snake plant and other smaller varieties of crotons, sir. Other than that, flowering plants would be a little difficult, but there are also a few miniature flowering plants which we can go for.
What are the advantages of vertical gardens?
Space utilization, sir, because in many campuses we won't have enough space. Given vertical gardening, we can utilize that space. And also in public infrastructure like roads and bridges, this would prevent the defacing of the walls by giving an aesthetic sense to that, sir. And also it's good in absorbing pollution. Yeah.
Also it improves the biodiversity of the region.
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, sir, I can hear you, sir.
Also, it reduces the ambient temperature of the region. Now, you have taken sociology as your option, is it not?
Yes, sir.
Now, tell me, what is the social impact of gated communities?
Yes, sir. Gated communities in itself is a form of isolation, sir. The rich tend to isolate themselves, whereas the poor are isolated by condition. And gated communities are one such phenomenon of the seclusion of rich, sir. And it creates a feeling of alienation among the other marginalized communities, who were the people who initially constructed those buildings, and in the end, they can't get to access to such buildings. It leads to alienation among them, sir. And recently, in the coronavirus pandemic also, the gated communities have said to keep their own rules, which is more stricter than the government rules. I came across an issue like that, sir, where people from outside are not allowed to use the lifts and elevators.
So,
during coronavirus, and they were...
If you speak like a sociologist, sorry to interrupt, if you speak like a sociologist, one is alienation.
Yes, sir.
Elimination becomes an important issue. What else is, as a sociology student, what else can you see from gated communities as an impact?
It is marginalization of existing class differences, and also the impact of nuclear family and new forms of living, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Does it also lead to a mindset which is where a set of people are not really concerned about the whole welfare of the society as such?
In particular, I don't believe that, sir. They are isolated geographically, but I don't think they are isolated socially. They are also involved in all forms of activity, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, what is your preference for services?
Sir, IAS in the first preference, sir. Second preference, IRS IT. Third preference, IRS Customs. Fourth preference, IFS, sir. And fifth preference, IFS.
Fifth is Foreign Service. So you don't like the police, basically?
Not like that, sir.
You're putting the IPS below the IRS.
Sir, for me, if anyone puts in IPS, if anyone wants to become IPS, they have to put it in first preference, sir, because that service demands so much commitment and dedication to its own, sir. And I believe one shouldn't accidentally become an IPS and one should want to become an IPS. For me, that kind of passion is towards IAS, sir. And I don't want to accidentally end up in IPS, sir.
So you got any role models in IAS?
Yes, sir.
Who is he or she?
It's Mr. Gagandeep Singh Bedi, sir. Because... in 2004, in my district, Cuddalore district, there was a tsunami event, sir, you all know. And the fatalities were nearly 500, and 5 fatalities were there. That time, Mr. Gagandeep Singh Bedi was our district collector. And everyone who were the citizens of Cuddalore were reciting his name, like, sir would come, sir would provide the relief works and all. And as a child, I looked up to him, and slowly I got interested into IAS. And, like, I too want to be there in the crisis management.
Why only one Bedi? Why not everybody becomes the same? All administrators and all. What is lacking in the Indian bureaucracy? Why only some examples of excellence? Not everybody becomes excellent.
Yes, sir.
Why so?
Sir, first thing, I believe there's a lack of motivation after entering into the services, sir. Mm-hmm. And the stagnation of talent, and thus political influence may also lead to lack of motivation. This could be few reasons why the efficiency is not up to the mark. But still, there are progresses everywhere, but only few come to the limelight. It's mainly because of anonymity of civil servants. And all civil servants are doing something or the little things to the society. And in the end, this would be massive change to the society, which is not extensive to themselves.
So... can you tell me a little bit about how do we move forward with China? The Sino-Indian standoff on the border, what are the major issues? How do we resolve it?
So the major issue is the unresolved boundaries which we have, which haven't been clearly demarcated between the two countries. We should solve that issue first to prevent these standoffs. And this should require political will and high-level discussions between the both countries, and should be completed in a fast post mission mode, sir. Because this lack of clarity is only leading to the standoffs, and it's also partly because of China's expansionist and aggression activities, which it is showing in almost all parts of the world, mainly the South China Sea, and its growing influence in South Asia. It is China's reaction against India's growing stature, sir.
But China is having disputes with around, I think, if I'm not wrong, it's around 18 countries they got territorial disputes. 18. So this is in their nature because a lot of economic power, they're flaunting that. They're showing with the military power. They had the first base they put in Djibouti. They put the first military base. They're flaunting their power and all. They don't bother about anybody. So everybody trying to corner them on Corona, but they're talking about something else.
Yes, sir.
How do we tackle a power like this?
So for to tackle China, we have to come united. So multilateral forums only should tackle China, sir. First, India should strengthen its foothold in South Asia, and then it should by reviving the SAARC mechanism, and then we should involve our Asian partners, and our allies like Russia and USA should also be taken on forefront. And the first thing would be focusing on making China accountable for the pandemic it has created. China flouting this its responsibility and showing its territorial aggression shows how irresponsible a nation can be. And multilateral forums should make sure that China is accountable for this massive pandemic, which has led to economic loss and livelihood loss. I believe multilateral forums is the key to bring China.
Yeah, you might have read the LAC, Line of Actual Control. There's something called LOC also. Are you aware of that? LOC?
Yes, sir. It's line of control in the India-Pakistan border side, sir.
Why it's called a line of control and line of actual control?
Sorry, sir. I've never
heard. What is the difference between LAC, LOC and the international border?
Sir, the international border is what the border which is India under India's claim, and the line of active control and line of control is the territorial ingressions made by Pakistan and China during wars, sir.
The international border, how do we define that?
Indeed. Sir?
How do we define the international boundaries? Like, if you call it international border, how do we define it? What is the definition of that? Which is not there in the case of LAC and LOC.
Sir, any international boundary should be recognized in our own constitutional laws. That is one way to ascertain an international boundary. And other thing would be natural geographical boundaries can also come under our boundaries, sir.
So international border is basically accepted by both the countries who share the border and recognized by the world.
Okay.
It's clearly demarcated. It may not be natural and maybe whatever is there, but basically accepted and recognized by the world. But that is not the case in LAC and LOC. You know how much area China is occupying Indian territory? How much area they are under Chinese occupation?
I'm not exactly
in square kilometers. Not there.
No, that's right.
Last, I want to ask, like Tamil Nadu, very hardworking people, very progressive and all. Literature is very rich, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Tamil literature. So we are proud of that. It's very rich language, very old language. But why is there so much animosity towards Hindi on Tamil Nadu only, not in other states of South India? Agitations against Hindi, is it political or?
This animosity was prevailed in 1960s, but now people are becoming progressive and open to all cultures. In 1960s, it was mainly due to the fear of exclusion from all services and fear of subsidization of one's own language. That led to agitation among public, and it was utilized by the political people to claim the power, sir. But right now, if we are assimilating the cultures, and Hindi is being actively learned by all the students in India, in Tamil Nadu, sir.
Is it being taught in the government schools?
No, sir.
No, no?
Yes,
so
sir.
I think this is something which is expected by the politicians to mobilize the votes, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Political will should be there to implement this three language system, sir.
Mm-hmm. So anything little bit about the Corona, how we handled it and how we handle it? We are not through. We're still fighting it. Corona pandemic, how we handled it?
I believe India has performed well in coronavirus management, sir. Yes, sir. Because India in itself is a unique country which we can't compare with any other country, sir. Because we are reading news reports about how New Zealand tackled corona. But New Zealand has population of only 26 million, which is not even the population of Chennai city. So tackling coronavirus in such a large scale in a country like this and maintaining the mortality rate below and having a high recovery rate, I believe we have managed corona well, sir. But the one thing where we missed out is the issue of migrant workers. Since they were not covered under any social safety security net, sir. That should have been our focus. And I believe since we never met a crisis like this before in our history, it was little unprecedented. But still, states like Kerala had performed very well. Indeed, they made the access of shelter and food to migrant workers using all the data and all the infrastructure they had, sir. So Kerala performed very well. And another example would be Dharavi, sir. Nowhere in the world can we management like that, sir. Because in a 10 by 10 square feet, 10 people are there. Social distancing is virtually impossible. But even in that, the Bombay Municipal Corporation has made sure that coronavirus rate has come down. And they have managed well, and the World Health Organization has also acclaimed it, sir. So I believe we have managed it pretty well, sir. And other issues, we have to now focus on other issues like bringing students back to education, providing migrant workers the facilities in their own rural areas. And that should be our focus, sir. And health disease management should also come gain priority in disaster management. So,
what are the three best lessons we have learned from Corona?
Yes, sir.
Good lessons.
Thing would be personal hygiene, sir. Yeah. Washing hands. The importance of washing hands has become more critical. And the second thing would be the evil effects of globalization, how a fallout in one country could affect the entire world. So the importance of self-reliance, where the country can stand on during a crisis. Self-reliance is the second thing, sir. And third thing would be inclusion, the negative effects of exclusion. If inclusion is there, they will be able to ward off themselves from any crisis, sir. Because in this pandemic, the high income group and middle income group were able to shield themselves and were able to survive in the lockdown. Whereas the most affected were the people below poverty line. And we should make sure that we include all the people in all the services, sir.
What about the family, like people forced to spend time with their families for a long time, sitting at home, which they were always running around, but now they're sitting indoors. So what about the family?
Family as an institution, one negative compound is that the domestic violence, where women are not able to escape their perpetrators and they have no help outside also. Before they can go outside, they can seek help from police station or from their mother house. But this component got missing in a family system, sir. And we should have given periodic counseling through TV and through advertisements of the need to keep citizens engaged, and also we should have requested them and we should have put a moral obligation on them that you are in our national duty to stop this pandemic and let us all work together. We should have focused on the internal issues in a family also, sir.
Thank you. One last, what about the environment? We were reading news that first time the animals are coming out of this thing and the environment is so clean. So lockdown, I think if you talk about global warming and all, it's not advisable to observe lockdowns every year. Maybe 2-3 weeks.
It is indeed a good idea, sir. But we have to plan it accordingly. Which all sectors can we put in lockdown? And if we come out with a very well prepared strategy, like schools are not polluters exactly, so schools can function. Maybe the transportation sector could come under a lockdown for a few days. If we plan it and execute it, of course, we can bring in a positive change to environment also, sir.
The quality of water, quality of air, visibility and all. I was reading the newspaper that in Punjab, from Jalandhar city, you can see hills which are 160 kilometers away in Kangra. So that's the first time people have seen, no generation has seen that. So it's a very good impact of lockdown. I think we should practice that as a
species. Just like the odd even policy which restricted vehicles one day, next day, we could go for this selective lockdown in selective cities and we can vouch for the change. So for cities like Delhi, this would be very a very good plan to go forward, sir.
Thank you. I Sarangi sir, to please give the feedback to you.
Yes.
Yeah. I asked some of the current affair questions from science, and like the fifth force, and what else?
Gravitational waves.
And the gravitational waves you are acquainted, but the fifth fundamental force, they have not yet decided, but then there is a talk that there can be a fifth fundamental force also. Okay. And the great Rinasa, Ethiopian Rinasa Dam, that's the Nile, that's the biggest one, the biggest project of the world now. That will change the entire water scenario of North Africa. Okay. So, but when you are opting for Indian services, these Indian boundaries, you must be very thorough. Okay, boundaries. So, the chairman asked you LOC and LSE. Actually, with Pakistan, we have our entire border is 3323 kilometers. Out of that, up to Jammu, it is international border. Okay. LOC starts, LOC was earlier ceasefire line. Now it has been described as per 1948 agreement. So now it's the LOC. From there, 700 some kilometers are LOC. Then there is something called actual ground position line, AGPL. That is 110 kilometers. AGPL, 110 kilometers. And that ends in North Junction, NJ 98842 or something, some junction point. From there, that goes towards north towards the glacier. So because of that anomaly, the line follows from NJ 98842 north towards the glacier. Which part is that? There's an anomaly. So that is why Pakistan is telling that Siachen is ours. We are telling no, Siachen is ours. So the triangle between Siachen Glacier, Indira Point, and Karakoram Pass, these three are the trouble points now. So far as the AGPL, the last part, is concerned. Okay. So be very thorough about it, because Indian boundary must be very thorough. On the eastern side, this side, with China, we have two major problems. One is the Aksai Chin on the north, and Tawang or Arunachal on the eastern side. Okay. So, as to why these things are happening, you will be very thorough about it. Because, otherwise, your interview is very good, but I had a feeling that you are very fast. You are talking very fast. So, as if you have mocked up things, just you are just going on telling. So, be a little slow in your speed. Because you are talking to somebody, it must register in his mind. Okay. So, just a little slow. Pitch is all right, but speed, you should increase a little. Because I found that it's a little fast. Okay. So that's all that I suggest. Thank you. Thanks.
Mr. Dipalan?
Yeah, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Now only I'm able to hear
you. Yeah. So I was saying that the speaking part, you know, maybe I completely agree with Sarangi, sir. Slightly on the higher speed, you know. Maybe you could make a conscious effort to reduce it. There's no problem as such, but you could try it. Now, whatever is mentioned in your this application, the DAF here, can be a source for discussion. So when you mention about Asian dramas, obviously, I mean, maybe TV serials may not be asked as a question, but Asian drama is a very important book. So that can be a source for discussion. So maybe you could spend some time, create some 2-3 points, because at the end of the day, the interview of one question is not going to be for 5 minutes, I don't think. It's going to be 1 or 2 minutes. So maybe you could prepare for 1 or 2 minutes. And also about sociology, it may not be always be theoretical question. It could be what is your observation from the surrounding. Gated communities is something which is happening. So, or the social implication of pandemic. So something of that sort could be a source for a discussion. But when you are asked a question as a sociology student, try to use more of sociology terms. That will help you. Otherwise, you come across a very confident person. All right, sir.
I think overall, I am quite satisfied with what you have said and all. So, I think Mr. Dipanan has also told, when you are asking a question, you should little pause for 5-10 seconds, and as if you are thinking.
Okay, sir.
Yes. So little bit acting is required, no? You are trying to imbibe, then react and all. So a little bit dramatics has to be there. So that will impress the board more than what you are doing. And you are very intelligent. I know that you are good academics and all. Then sociology, I was thinking of asking clash of civilizations like that. No? So they're very well-learned people. Clash of civilization, Chomsky and all those things. Then relate to Tamil Nadu or India. Any famous sociologist from India, what theory they have given then? One of them, I think, died only recently. You know that? One Indian sociologist died only 2 months back. So you check up the newspapers and see what theory he has given and also please go through that. And otherwise, you are doing very well. And China, like, what is the dispute? How do we go forward? International pressure, but India is trying to bring through Quad and United Nations and all those things and all. So you put the points in writing, try to say the most important. Answer maybe 1.5 minutes to 2 minutes, not more than that. So be very crisp. And gravitational force also, you should be able to, gravitational waves, you should be able to define what sir was asking. So if you do not know, just tell them, sir, sorry, sir, I am not aware, I don't know that. Isn't it? When is the interview?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When is the interview?
July 21st, Tuesday.
So that's the first, I think. So you can have 1 week just to brush up everything that's happening.
Yes, sir.
And that Corona COVID-19 in Chennai is very serious and all. So they may ask questions on that also. Why in Chennai they are not able to control? What are special factors there?
Okay, so sir.
Remember, with this question was asked by your faculty members, Mr. Satya is there. So you can have a word with him also, then what, how you should formulate the answer and all. You will do well. You're very confident. All the best to you.
Thank you.
And little more, the western border is extremely important because we have all the time saying that POK is ours. Okay. POK, Gilgit, Baltistan, etc., they are ours. And that has completely stopped us, seized us from Afghanistan, because Afghanistan has also a border with India. But because of POK, that border is gone. We cannot enter into the Central Asia. Okay, so that is one of the very important questions that the chairman asked you, entire this western border. Okay, yes, just have a little look into that.
Yes, sir.
We have shown the Indian map also that has been revised recently. Just go through that map also, no? Which government of India just around 2 months back. So they show Indian territory. Please go through that. Thank you. Do well.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Bye-bye.